job is to remove a pine tree. It's a big one. It's like 87.2 feet tall. And this guy's leaning over my buddy Jim's house, just like right over the house. I gotta ask him when I get there, like, dude, why didn't you take care of this when the tree was small? But the tree's big now, and he's gonna help out. Jim's gonna run the ground operation while I run the chopping up in the air, and we'll see how it goes.
Difficult week for DCM and Asian. Is this idea that it
All right, so here's Jim's leaning pine. He said it was actually topped maybe 10 years ago, like natural disaster topped, and grew that secondary stem up there. You can sort of see a little dog leg up there. It's got a good lean to it, just so you can kind of tell, like, this would be vertical, something like that. So it's got a lean right over his house. We're gonna drop stuff down in here where he's working, and then move it over to the Green Beast. All right, now Jim's got a pretty funky array of chains and bells and bird feeders and stuff, so it's getting a little bit medieval. So I gotta tell you, man, this is the first time I've ever rigged up around a bell, you know? we got chains hanging everywhere.
Well, those, a lot of them are hanging birds.
Okay, I got the chain.
Okay.
Here you go. You got it? You know, I gotta say, I've never really seen this kind of thing. It's almost like a rigging setup. So we definitely have some straps and chains in play from our top up here. A couple more rounds and I'll get that stuff free. So you climbed up here and screwed this stuff all in here.
Yeah.
That's awesome. You use a ladder or something?
Uh-uh.
No.
Nah, jump up to the first branch.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, monkey style.
Old school. I like it. All right, this one's coming down right here. I think you're clear. All right, chains are coming loose. Chain number one. This is actually a strap, not a chain. Oh man, this bus is just like squeezing through. Oh, that was like a lot heavier than I thought it would be. Since you're there, we could tag team it.
Okay.
And can you reach that end?
This one?
Yeah. A little bit?
I had it in a second.
Just let me know when you're over there ready to toss.
One.
On
three?
We're doing, yeah, that's two. And three. There's just a lot of unorthodox stuff going on. I like it. So I'm just setting up my solo rigging setup for these limbs, which basically what I do, you've probably seen this before, I just anchor kind of up high, and that's where the rope's just gonna stay. So this is my like semi-permanent spot, and then I'm just anchoring everything with this loop right here. That way I can pull the rope through and retrieve it each time. I don't know if that's clear, but let's just do it. Clicked on, held up above, Jim's out of the way, let's cut. I pulled up one of Jim's bird feeders. Squirrel feeder? I don't know what that is. You ready? All right, here's where we're at. Getting up there, gotta rig out a few more of these guys, and right here is our little turn. This is where the tree was originally busted and then sent out another sprout. All right, we are up over the point of the dog leg on the tree, just kind of clearing some of this stuff out, rigging it down, and then we'll talk about what we're gonna do with the top. Yeah, I'm good. Send up a bottle.
Stretch member clear in there.
Oh, good, yeah.
Using it as hand sanitizer.
I bet that does the trick. All right, so this guy is gonna flop, and then I'll kind of lower it, and Jim will come out after taking a break and catch it, maybe? Same deal, just rigging out some of this over the house stuff. Trying to preserve the radio antenna and the trampoline. All right, so this top seems good to me. It's that newer growth, but I'm not really worried about it. It's pretty vertical. I mean, for a leaning tree. What are we doing? We're just taking out a few more of these overhangs before we drop the top. This thing's got a little swing to it.
Getting lively up here.
What's that?
By the time it hits the ground, it's whistling.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Whistling?
Yeah, there's a rush of air. Not whistling, exactly.
All right, I think because of the wind and everything, we're gonna do a tag line on the top.
That's what I'm thinking.
I don't know what you're thinking, but I'm thinking tagline on the top. You know, tag it, pull it. Trailer's getting pretty full. Let's do that tagline thing on the top. What the fuck was that? Is that a bat? Oh, it's a squirrel. Go, squirrel. We got a squirrel coming down. Yeah, it was up here.
Oh, man.
It just ran by me. Did it make it down?
It will.
he's almost down. There he goes.
You stole the bird seed.
That's it. He's gone. He's gone. So that's a notch. You got a little bit of tension. It's not gonna take, it's like very light, it's very small. I'll put a cut in it, then I'll kill the saw, and then you'll just pull it over. Okay? And there's no rush, you're just kind of holding it.
Right.
So it doesn't go the other way. All right, let's ease her over. Here we go. Nicely done.
Wow.
That was good, man. I'm gonna drop a couple logs. I'll just put them right there.
Yeah, they're whistling by the time I get down here.
Is that right? No. I'm getting a little chunky. I might have to switch saws here in a minute. That'd be a good chance to warm up because I'm kind of freezing. I don't know if I mentioned, it's like 26 degrees. I don't know, man, that little echo is still going. Might be one more chunk with the echo. Echo chunk. Now, I don't know if I got through on that one. Oh yeah, it's through. There we go. I'm gonna go down, get some warm tea, thaw my hands out, and then I'm gonna come back up with a bigger saw. So I got the big boy going back up to chop logs. I was thinking about dropping it, the whole thing right here, but that's a little sketchy, so I'm gonna drop logs. Plus we got these little hooks and stuff to play with. I've been thinking, I kind of need a smaller big saw. Starting getting into the hooks and stuff, so I cut this one a little short so I can avoid that stuff. Big tipper. Come on. There we go. Hey Jim, can you grab that red rope again? Yeah. Awesome. Thank you. Like you got it. Kaboom. Good job. That was a messed up hinge. That was like the worst notch I've ever done. It worked. Alright, now I'm just gonna say that a fella could get a little bit soft working that way. You know, with Jim just loading everything up, it was just like a cutting job, not a hauling job. So anyway, thanks for checking out the project. I've said it before, but it bears repeating, that this is not actually like a how-to video. I'm not saying like, you should do it this way. I'm just saying this is the way I did it. Thanks for checking it out, and I'll see you in the next project.